Amit Saha, respected Shri Sumit Gupta, esteemed officials of FICCI, and my friends assembled here. A very good morning to you. I wouldn't reiterate the grim statistics with regard to road accidents in India. That doesn't need reiteration. A couple of years ago, when Mr. Gadkari asked me to help out with the communications part of it, the idea was to see how we can communicate the need to be a responsible road user better. And there are three key aspects which I would like to focus on over here. And I'm aware and I'm fully appreciate the wonderful work which many of the companies are doing via their CSR budgets. The first area is like innovative new age media communications when it comes to road safety. Leveraging, we made a start 1.5 years ago with a contest on road safety stories, and the best stories, the best 20 stories came out in the form of a book, which was released day before yesterday by the Honorable Minister. It's called Have a Safe Journey, the world's first collection of short stories on road safety. Now, when you leverage literature, it doesn't get limited, and you curate good stories. It doesn't get limited to just those 20 stories coming out in the form of a book. It forms the foundation of a possible, with digital series of short films. And fortunately, with so many digital channels available today on the YouTube, the sky is the limit if you want to really make it viral. Now, the challenge over here is that road safety being a grim issue, the reiteration need not be grim. It has to be very subtle. I'll give you an example. A couple of years ago, Big FM 92.7 used to have this radio series called UP Ki Kahaniya. That isn't the best example because you know what happened to the UP government after that. But then, instead of focusing, what that show used to do, I followed that show, very subtly that used to, within normal stories, romantic stories, emotional stories, very subtly it used to bring out one, every episode, one key aspect of the development work which the government was doing. Obviously, that government probably wasn't doing enough because it failed, the show failed. But what I'm trying to tell you over here is that curated stories, emotional stories, which are watchable purely on the merit of them being romantic stories, but then the road safety aspect is seeded in a way that you can't miss it. A lover dying in a road accident, but then that's one part of the story. You leave a message how rash driving can, could have, responsible driving could have, led the couple to be a couple for a longer period of time. So the options right now, right from the overhead media, right from the 2-minute films which you can display on metro stations, the options are humongous. And this is where you probably, I'm just throwing a few ideas, corporates over here may come out to support these. Maybe a portal where you encourage people to write a daily experience of their road safety experience across the country. Those could come out as, subsequently come out as a 1-minute or a 90-second story played out, at metro stations through the overhead outdoor media. The second aspect which I wish to focus is, despite the Good Samaritan law, despite the provisions of despite the regulations of the Supreme Court, which clearly state that a good Samaritan helping somebody who, an accident victim, will not be questioned or unnecessarily harassed by the police. Unfortunately, even now, there is very little awareness about it. And I would also link it to, the education about what you need to do in an emergency situation. We have Dr. Maya Tandon over here, who's been doing exceptional work on emergency care. And I lately have been taking up this up with the officials in the ministry. I think if the communication could shift towards, the idea that I'm a potential lifesaver, because many of the people, either for want of time or for sheer apathy, Even if they see an accident victim, they usually don't stop. And in many cases, it's also because they don't know what exactly to do. They're scared to touch an accident victim. So if the focus could shift on, I'm a potential lifesaver and I need to know essentially how to save a life in, or how to, you know, what is the way, best way to take a patient to the nearest medical care center while observing all the safety methods. I think this communication is required. In fact, subsequently, we can have a, like I said, we can link it with a larger communication. We can have a Good Samaritan of the Month award, because these stories need to encourage many other people to similarly come forward and help accident victims, which unfortunately still hasn't been happening the way it should have happened. And the third and most crucial part is how we make this a mass movement. The first two things which I mentioned were leading up to it, but essentially all of that has to converge into a larger plan to make it a mass movement. It has to be linked to your responsibilities as a responsible citizen, as a caring citizen of the country. Towards that, we have started, you know, whenever road safety sessions from the ministry or otherwise have happened across the country, those sessions have ended with us giving a pledge to students to drive safe. Because essentially, in many cases, it has to work the other way, not from seniors, but juniors telling their parents. So in fact, I would just like to mention about another project which the ministry is supporting recently. And Mahindra Trucks and Buses is sponsoring that through their CSR initiative. It's truck drivers' road safety experiences told in first person by their daughters. So it merges two issues, girl-child education and road safety. And we've got some brilliant stories told by truck drivers' daughters about how an accident has changed their life and how, you know, responsible driving has actually saved them from possible fracas or possible, you know, sad situations. When we talk about making it a mass movement, obviously we need to take it to as many schools and colleges. And one of the ideas which I had been working on a year ago, which unfortunately didn't see the light of the day, was to possibly engage the best 20 engineering and management and possibly medical colleges also, and to have road safety dialogues on the key areas which concern their education. For example, the engineering students could do a thesis or could work on the engineering aspects of road safety. The management students could work on how better management, and that includes time management, because time management is the core of most accidents. You start late and then you rush. So management students could look at management solutions to road safety, and medical students could probably look at more emergency care or better facilities which can save lives. There is a need to initiate these dialogues in the best medical colleges, in the best management colleges, and the best engineering colleges, because community hall gathering in every city or possibly 50 cities across the country, which ends with us giving some further responsibilities to these college kids to take it across the city, maybe form a human chain of as many students as possible, can lead to a significant change in the way we look at road safety. It's an attitude, really, which needs to change, and that is what we are working towards. So my role, like I said, is largely about the communications part. It's about impacting the attitudes and changing attitudes. I would encourage any possible suggestions which we can take it forward. I'll give you my email ID at the end of it, but I look forward to your support and to take it to another level. Thank you very much.